Now you have to use the coaching. This is very important. You have to use the coaching angles. Because now you stand in front of them. You said, one, two, three. You finish, you said they should do it. Maybe somebody is seeing your face, somebody can just see your back. So you need to turn and demonstrate again. You need to turn and demonstrate again. And make sure that they all have the information. That is coaching. You understand? Then you can ask maybe one of them to do it for you to see. If he does, he does it correct, then you can ask everybody to do it. You understand? Yeah. He doesn't need that angle. You, the coach, you use that angle to teach them. So he has to demonstrate what you want him to do. And after he demonstrates, as he's demonstrated, you have a problem. You have a problem to solve. If there is a problem with the legs, you have to correct it. If whatever, so you, the coach, you are watching to make sure that you can see the mistake. You, the coach, always looking for where the mistakes are. Correct. Coach, this boxer is calling your attention. He's doing something. He's thinking that you will correct him. But you are not correcting him. He's trying to call your attention. When you say straight punches, he's throwing hooks. But your mind was not on him. He changed again. He started doing uppercut. Your mind was not on him. You understand? So he's not carrying your instruction. So you, the coach, must be able to see him. Yes, and that is your way.
Yes. Okay. Guard on. I command forward. I command back out. I command side. The side kill up. First kill up, forward. One. Second kill up, back out. One. Third kill up, side, side. Okay?
Box. Not just championship. We have to have some different boxers. Some are bad, just rushing. Now you have to be clear on what? Defense. We have to learn fast defense. Right. Suddenly we have to sweat fast, then we do some what? Running a bit. Then afterwards, then we shall go to what? Defense.
Side.
This is another form of skipping. This is another form of skipping. So they will be generating heat still. And so now that if you want them to do the main stretching, they should be working on the what? The joints where the fluid is ready now. And you take part in the stretching, but you didn't take part in the jogging. And you are the same person coming to do the main stretch. You'll be growing, and your body will change. So you cannot do every exercise by using your own demonstration. But you have boxers who can understand. So if you are in the form of main stretch, you ask maybe you lead the main stretch, then he lead the main stretch. If maybe you pair them, maybe you and you do the main stretch, you and you do the ministry. So they pair together, maybe they decide, let's bring our hands together, maybe let's do something. Maybe there are so many ways they can do the ministry by themselves. So you need to instruct them to do it. Maybe I have to help the hand for him, and he also has to help my hand for me. So we pair and do the whole thing. So that when you take over the training, you'll be doing the training and you will get tired. And the boss says, so you not even, when you get tired, you cannot correct them again.
All right, let's start with the elbow. Hold the elbow. Hold one, two, three, four, five. Bend down. One, two, three, four,
okay, good.
Five.
This is what I wanted to be seeing, you see. That is, so you are the coach. You want to do some? If you do some, who will correct them? Let's consider that you are doing the main stretch. Do this one. And then you do different things. If you are not standing, how do you correct this one? You see? You understand? So you should know how your role as a coach is very, very important.
To know how to tap. You want all of us to use what? To use javelin. Your hands have to be in.
Yes. Then you are doing coaching. Yeah.
And you all stand. All of you. This place is very important. Okay? Don't drop your hands.
You tap it. That means we call it what? Tapping. Tap. If you bring jab, you tap it. Okay?
Use the right hand to tap.
You use the right hand. Okay? One. Okay, let's go one.
So as you do this, you check the angle. Okay. So that it's very important for all of them to see what you are coaching. Coach, you see why I said it's very important for assistant coaches. Because now your concentration is here. And these people too are doing another thing.
Yeah.
And nobody is watching them to correct them. So it's better, maybe he must be your assistant coach. And you have the objective. And so when you are concentrating on these people, he can also check these people for you. So assistant coach is very, very important. You see? So if you don't have, you use another boxer to do that.
The period. Which period is that? Special training period. So you need to let it show here as well. And then
that 1 hour, you can tell them 1 hour, but you don't ask them whether they can 1 hour or not, because you assume that they can. Maybe during the training, you realize that they cannot, then you stop. You understand? Because for now, it's like you don't know their fitness level. That is why you are asking them, will they land, will they last? Because if you, the coach, you know their fitness level, then you don't need even to ask them anything. You just program for them, and then you follow the program. Because you know them, they are your boxers. You know their fitness level. I hope it's clear.
Alright,
so let's assume that you talk to them, they understand what you want to do. So do what you want to do.
Let's organize, arrange ourselves, and let's kick off with our training. We're going to begin our training with simple light stretches called mild stretches. Very simple. In your positions. You can hold your head over and cross your hands all the way. Hold your head and take all the sides and just relax your neck. All right, let's try that. Cross arms, everybody. Cross your arm over your head. Back it all the way to your elbow side.
Okay, coach. consider that you finish the warm up. What are you going to do next?
We're ready for the warm up. We're going to do a technical training program for today, and we're starting with some movements. Let's stand in fighting positions. Please organize your legs. Put your hands up on your head. Alright. Reach up, keep your hands up on your head. Organize your legs. Are you doing you're doing orthodox? So your elbows on your stomach, head in. Good job. Alright, everybody in your position. So we do some simple slight movements just to get ourselves ready. And in front, one step backward. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, let's go. Step in,
coach,
and step out.
You need to demonstrate first before you ask them to do that.
Okay.
You cannot just go straight.
Okay, so everybody, watch me. This is what we do. We step in, and then step out. Step in, and step out. Step in. And step up. But you come inside and I'll show you all so that we all see what step. We all see that? I'll try that. Everybody try front and back. Very good. Very good. Okay, stop, stop. I think he does it better. Let's all see what he's doing, everybody. Focus, focus. Very good. Very good. Okay, now after this, now everybody, with your inner sub movement, I want us to be throwing some punches, and we're going to start with the front hand, the jab.
Coach,
right?
Just now you teach them,
yes.
And after teaching them, you saw that he is doing it well. You make him, that's it, and then now you are moving to another subject. You let them all do again, and then you watch, before you move to another subject. Because now, he is doing well. The others are not doing well. And so you want to have them. Uh-huh. So you need to, don't just jump. Just relax. They are just going to show their mistakes. I hope it's clear. So you work according to the program that you have. And you need assistance. Don't forget that. And the things that you are doing. Now, how many minutes are you doing it? Who is controlling that minute? We are doing this maybe 10 minutes. There's somebody who will say, tie. Yeah? Maybe that person will be a stopwatch. If you don't have that, then maybe there must be a stopwatch that is there, and then it will give the signal. King, 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 or prang, prang, or something. To make some noise for you to know that it's time. I hope it's clear. So that you can control the time. Because you were talking about 1 hour training. So it must be specific within the 1 hour training. Because the 1 hour training must have some effect. 1 hour training must have some effect. And you are working in a special training period. So special training period. That means it must be boxing what? Specific. So boxing specific. So there some mistakes, you must improve upon that mistakes. So let's assume that they finish the work. What are they going to do now? They finish the work you are asking them to do. What's the next? We are now going to do the main program. What's the main training program? Heavy back. Heavy back. So heavy back, what are they going to do on the heavy back? Yes. Now you ask them to be doing forward and backwards. They are doing the movement forward and backwards. So when you move to the punching bag, it should be a follow-up. Because you don't do different things and you improve it in a different thing in the punching bag. It doesn't connect. So if they are working, they are going to work on a punching bag. They are going to do heavy. Then you must do it as you are doing this, and then you move that to what?
The back.
To the back. I hope you understand. Because if they do different thing here, and they go and do different thing also in their body part, what are they developing? They are not developing anything. You see? So you must know your training, know where you are going. You understand? Yeah. So let's consider they finish the heavy bag that we are talking about. What are they going to do with it? They are going to do what? You don't say they are going to stretch. You say they are going to do cool down. Because the kind of stretching you do for warm up is different from the kind of stretching you do for what? Cool down. So you must understand all. Oh, so it's not just stretching, but it's what? Cool down. Okay. So I hope you are all. We will continue. I know it's not going to be easy, but with time. To be scientific is very, very important. So, group four. The fluid is ready. So there's no need for my stretch again. Then it should be what?
Main stretch.
So let's consider that you finish the main. Let's consider you finish the
What's warm up?
So what? Okay, you are going to do warm up. What they do now? What they did now? What is it?
They first warm up. They stretch now, they're going to shell boxing.
So it's not warm up.
Shell boxing.
It is your main program.
Moving time. They're not moving. Don't put your hands in the chest, pull it out. Try to get out.
What are you?
Yeah. How is their practice now? How they are going to be? How collective they are? What collective? What should be the part of
our that means it's not going to be a speed pathway for coming.
No, something conditional.
Just relax, need to be off. Okay. Okay, it's okay. We have more time, don't worry, we'll do more. I just want to have a clear understanding of what you are doing. So after this, what are you going to do next?
I'm going to school combat. As you do. Now I'm going to train 1-2. Give me 1-2. Go. But go hit down.
Coach,
the position is
you and your assistant, which I can't understand. I don't know whether your assistant coach is a boxer.
Assistant coach itself is what? The boxer.
She's pairing up. She's pairing up because she has no.
And so then you don't need to go to correct it as bad coach.
Correct.
You need to watch the vocal. Because that is that coach will take care of that side.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so how many times?